This series of videos is intended for ITC personnel, but may also benefit district staff in explaining the cause of the 103 errors. ITC assistance is usually required. The EIS 103E may generate three types of errors. It will display the tag number and error, and then a description of the error. This video covers the first type of error that may be generated, which is the ending balance amount not equal to the item's original cost. The following formula is used for each active item on the 103. The ending balance amount is the total amount of the item's acquisitions entered this year, plus the item's beginning balance amount, which is stored in the beginning info section of the item's domain and data tree. The ending balance amount should equal the item's original cost from item screen. If it doesn't, the error message is issued and the item is not included on the 103 report. To determine the cause of the error, in item screen, make note of the original cost for the item. Also verify that the acquisition date is in the current year or if it was entered in a prior year. An acquisition transaction, add up the current year acquisition amounts against this item. The 103 only looks at acquisition transactions with the date in the current year. For each item found, double check that the update original cost flag is set to yes. So far in our example, the sum of all the current year acquisitions for this item is $10,000. The beginning balance is unknown, and the original cost is $10,000. If the beginning balance amount is zero, this formula would be correct. If that was the case, there wouldn't be a 103 error report, so we need to look at the beginning balance amount for further information. You want to ready the item's domain of data tree to find the beginning balance for this item. You may do so by doing Ready Items Shared Modify, find a collection and items with inventory tag equal to that inventory number, and list all beginning info. If the item was added in the current fiscal year, the fields in the beginning info section should be blank. Why? Because the beginning info data for this item will not populate until EIS close runs for the current fiscal year. If you find it has already been set, in particular the beginning balance, this is the cause of the error. Using data tree, remove all the beginning info data. For our example above, all but the beginning balance amount is empty. That beginning balance amount is the cause of the error. If this item was added this fiscal year, all fields in this section should be blank. Using data tree, blank out the beginning balance amount. An example might be modify all using beginning balance equals quotation marks. Rerun the 103 and the 103E report should no longer generate. If the item was added in a prior fiscal year, you want to look at the beginning balance data in data tree. There should be data in this section, and the capitalized beginning of year should be set to yes. Why is that? Because when EIS close ran at the end of that year, it populated this section for any new capitalized items added during that year. If there were additional acquisitions posted against this item during the current fiscal year, add those amounts to the beginning balance from data tree. This total ending balance should equal the original cost. If not, the district needs to determine which is correct, the ending balance or the original cost, and with help from the ITC, make the necessary adjustments. Please refer back to the video selection for other EIS 103 error videos.